everyone. I'm Retro Bill, your D.A.R.E. safety buddy. I'm going to take you on an exciting journey through the world of safety.
Cool.
I'm going to be your guide as you learn the lessons of how to be safe, drug-free, and violence-free. Right on. Let's get started. Follow me. Hey, whoa, where are you going, Lewis and Clark? Follow me. This way. This is a good place for our first safety tip. Why is it safer to follow directions?
Oh.
Well, imagine what the world would be like if we didn't follow directions and ignored traffic signs and signals. Everything would be out of control, and a lot of people would get hurt. Following directions and obeying signs and signals while walking, riding a bike, or in a car is very important. Don't walk. It tells you that for good reason. Look what awaits you if you walk when it says not to. Pretty dangerous. Walk. Now that it tells you to walk, it's safe to go. But always remember the golden rule. Look both ways before you cross the street. All clear. This sign means pedestrian crossing. If you're walking, this sign lets you know that this is where you should cross the street. And if you're in a car or on a bike, you should always yield to the crossing pedestrian. Hey, a traffic light.
Cool.
Do you know what the colors of a traffic light stand for?
No.
Let me tell you. Green means go, move, scram, get along, giddy up.
Rolling, rolling, rolling.
Yellow means slow. Some people think yellow means hurry up. It doesn't. It means
slow down.
The light's about to change. Red means stop, halt, put on the brakes, go no further. Hey, where are you going, buddy?
Nowhere.
Always wear a safety helmet when riding a bicycle. Always. The stop sign is one of the most common signs around. Whether in a car or on your bike, always come to a complete stop when you're at a stop sign. Good thing I stopped. See if you can guess what this next sign means. This sign means railroad crossing. It lets you know that train tracks are ahead. When you come upon a flashing signal, make sure that you stop and let the train pass by. When the train's gone, the gate lets you move safely along. Don't clown around when there's a train around.
Whoa!
Hey, that rhymed.
Cool. Uh-oh, no bikes.
Uh-uh.
This is the international don't or no sign. Whatever's underneath this red symbol means it's not allowed there. No retro bill. No pedestrian crossing is a common sign. No skateboarding. No swimming. No hot dogs. No hot dogs. Just kidding.
Right on.
Shh. Hey, officer.
Hey, Retro Bill.
How's it going?
Fine, thank you.
Hey, let's hear your siren.
Sure.
Cool. Always wear a safety belt when riding in an automobile. Remember, it's the law.
Right on.
Why is it important to know what is going on around you?
Why is it important to know what's going on around you?
Oh.
Because knowing what's going on around you can keep you from getting hurt.
Oh.
Hey, heads up over there.
Ow.
See, he wasn't aware of what's going on around him. Hey, walk this way. Speed bump. Before you walk out from between parked cars, always make sure you look both ways before you step into the street. Coast clear, it's safe to go. Right on. Hey, you knocked my block off. We're having fun playing right now, but we're not playing smart. Let's play here. Ow, that hurt. The sidewalk is for skateboarding, riding your bike, or walking, not for sitting in everyone's way. Whoa, that was close. This is a safe and smart place to sit and play a game. And if you're aware of what's going on around you, you can stay safe.
I got it. Ooh.
Hey, he knocked my block off.
Cool.
Whoa. That wouldn't have happened if he had looked both ways before walking out from between these parked cars. Keep out. This means don't go there. A lot of the time, there aren't signs, fences, or rules to tell you what to do. That's when your common sense, cha-ching, tells you what to do or not to do.
Hey, keep out of there.
And remember, always wear a safety belt when riding in an automobile. Always wear a safety helmet when riding a bicycle, a scooter, or a skateboard. Oh, try Try and start every day with a smile, because it's kind of hard to be in a bad mood when you got a big smile on your face. Try it. See? It works. Right on. Whoa. Luckily, I saw that guy coming, or I would have been run over by the ice cream man. Huh? Ice cream?
Why shouldn't you take gifts or rides from strangers or people you don't know well?
Hey, kid. Want a piece of gum?
No, thank you.
How about a candy bar?
No, thanks.
Hey, how about a bag of circus peanuts?
No. I don't know this man. He's a stranger. You should never accept gifts or rides from strangers or people you don't know well. No matter what gifts they may try to offer you, don't accept them.
Oh, hey, I got a ticket to the amusement park. You want it? They got a new roller coaster.
Roller coaster? Say no to anything they might offer. No, thank you. Another trick strangers may use is to pretend they know you by reading your name on your clothes or on your school books.
Hey, Retro Bill, is this your $100 bill?
Nope. Never answer a stranger's questions. Never.
You know, I saw you missed your school bus. I could give you a ride wherever you want to go.
Never accept a ride from strangers. Once they get you in their car, you may never get away. And make sure that you walk a safe distance away from a stranger's car so the stranger can't reach out of their car and grab you.
Hey, kid.
And if a stranger drives alongside of you like this guy is doing to me, stop, turn, and walk the opposite way.
Hey. Kids.
3ABC, 123, Gray Ford Fairlane. 3ABC, 123, Gray Ford Fairlane. I'm writing down that guy's license plate number and the kind of car he drives in case I have to give it to the police or my parents. Make sure you tell an adult or police officer about what's happened when you've been approached by a stranger and give them any details you can about what's happened.
Good job, Retro Bill.
Right on. Hey, I've got bowling balls in my front yard. Wow.
Excuse me.
Yes? This woman seems nice, but she's still a stranger, so I'll remain a safe distance away up here on the curb in case she asks me any questions. Right on.
Do you know how to get to Los Angeles from here?
No. Sorry.
Okay, thanks anyway.
She seemed like a nice lady, but no matter how nice a stranger may seem to be, don't answer their questions. Don't accept any gifts. Don't accept a ride. And make sure you get to a safe place right away and tell an adult what has happened. Dino tip.
Hey, kid. Want to see my dog?
No, thanks.
It's a great dog. Does all kinds of tricks.
Never accept an offer to see a stranger's pet.
You sure? It's a really cool dog.
I'm sure. No, thanks. Another thing to be cautious about is the stranger that approaches you with one of these, a leash. And then they ask you to help them find their lost dog or cat. Don't fall for that one. If a stranger's lost their pet, let them find it. Cool. My bus. I'll go use the payphone and call for a ride. Good tip. If someone other than your mom or dad should show up to give you a ride home, make sure you have a secret code or a password the adult picking you up must know in order for you to know you're accepting a ride home from the right person and not a stranger. Hey, Retroville, I'm your ride home. What's the secret code? Only me, you, and your mom and dad know that it's Ram-a-lam-a-ding-dong. You're right. He's right. See?
Uh-huh.
Now I know he's not a stranger, and he's supposed to pick me up. See ya!
Who can you call in case of an emergency?
Oh! That hurt. Just kidding. Hey, this leads me to another safety tip. Who can you call in case of an emergency? What is an emergency? An emergency is any time you or someone else is hurt or in danger, like if you really did run your finger in the door, or if you slipped and fell and got hurt, or if a stranger is peeking in your window. Anytime you need to call for help, it's important to know who to call. First, you should know your own address and telephone number, including the area code. Cool! Always know the address and telephone number of where a parent can be reached if needed. Right on! Be able to give the name and location of the person who is to be in charge of you when you're away from home. Got it. Remember, an emergency is not running out of cereal, losing the TV remote, or any can't find your favorite toy. There you are, my green little buddy. 911 is not for fun. Dialing 0 or 911 is for emergencies. Right on. When your mom, dad, family member, or other trusted neighbor cannot be reached, then you should dial 0 for the operator or 911 for the police or fire department. Remember, if you don't have any money or a calling card, you can dial 0 or 911 in an emergency for free from a payphone. That's good to know. Make sure you know the name, number, and location of the person to be in charge of you when you're away from home. And know which family member or trusted neighbor is to be contacted. I'm dialing 911 right now because someone just threw a rock through my window and no one's at home to help me.
I'm scared.
But always remain calm as you clearly describe the emergency, because if they can't understand you, they might not provide the right help.
911?
Hello, 911. I have an emergency.
Go ahead.
No one is at home right now and someone just threw a rock through my window.
What's your name?
Retro Bill.
And what's your address?
1955 Sunset Drive.
Are you injured?
Luckily, no, but I'm scared.
All right. Well, since you're not injured, I won't send an ambulance. I'll just send the police.
Thank you.
Now stay calm and stay away from the windows and the doors.
And be very quiet. And that's what I heard and saw, officer.
Okay, Retro Bill.
When you call the police, make sure that you clearly give them any information you can about what has happened. Describe who you saw, what you heard, and any other details you can remember.
All the information you've given me should help me find the person who did this. Thank you for your help, Retro Bill.
Right on. Good morning, Colonel. A good safety tip is to have your parents help you make an emergency contact list. This should include the names and numbers of people you're to contact in an emergency. Place your list where it'll be easy to find when you really need it. You should keep a copy of your emergency contact list with you at all times so that you have it with you when you're away from home. Hey, I'm gonna go surf the web.
Why should you stay with your friends in public places?
Why should you stay with your friends in public places?
Oh.
Because staying with your friends in public places is a good way to keep safe.
Oh.
You may have heard the saying, there's safety in numbers.
Believe it!
I thought I'd drop in to give you a few tips on staying safe in public places. I like to refer to my take a friend or adult along with you when you're in a public place as the buddy system. Hey, buddy.
Hey, Retro Bill. Hey, he knocked my block off.
Right on. Always try to bring a friend or adult along with you whenever you go to the park, the mall, or any other public place. And always get permission from your parent or the adult in charge of you before going someplace like a friend's house, the arcade, or the mall. Never go into a public restroom alone. Whenever you can, take a parent, guardian, or a trusted friend with you. And never talk to a stranger in a public restroom. Right on! Never talk to a stranger, even if the stranger calls you by your name. They may have read it on a shirt, a school book, or a backpack, or may have gotten it some other way.
Hey, Halloran!
Everybody here is playing with a buddy. Not only is the buddy system safer, it's a lot more fun.
What should you do if you are not picked up on time?
It's getting late. What should you do if you're not picked up on time?
Oh.
Remaining calm and following certain safety rules can help you keep safe if you're not picked up on time. Never wait alone. Make sure that someone else, preferably a trusted adult or teacher, waits with you. Remember to know who to call in case this situation happens to you. Try to keep enough change on you to make a call if you need to. And remember to have your contact numbers memorized. Luckily, the numbers I don't have memorized, I have written on my emergency contact list. Oh, and if you don't have any money, dial 0 for the operator and calmly tell the operator what has happened to you. Ask the operator to place a collect call from you. And if the operator isn't helpful, ask to speak to the boss or supervisor.
Operator.
Hello, operator. It's going to be dark soon. Always make sure you stay in a safe, well-lit area close to the place you're supposed to be picked up in if it's getting too late. And it is dark, or someone's bothering you, go to the nearest payphone, dial 0, and ask the operator to connect you with the police. The police will come to drive you home or to another safe place.
Cool!
Never take a ride from anyone except from your parent, guardian, or other trusted adult who knows your secret code. Hot diggity dog, I'm out of here.
What should you do if you find a gun?
What should you do if you find a gun? Did I say gun? I sure did. Guns and other weapons are dangerous and should not be handled by kids, which is you. Never touch guns or bullets. Never touch other weapons such as knives. If you find a gun or other weapon, don't touch it. Tell your parent, a trusted adult, or the police about it.
Right on.
If your parent or guardian keeps a gun or weapon in the house, follow the safety rules that you've set up with them. Make sure that any gun stays unloaded and locked away. Bullets should always be kept away from where the gun is kept. Remember, don't touch or play with a weapon that is kept at home. It's just as dangerous as one you might find somewhere else. Did you know that every day approximately 6 children and teenagers are killed by gunshots? No way. Way? And of every 8 children who die before the age of 21, one child dies because he or she was shot. Man. Many kids have been killed or injured because they thought a real gun was a toy, or because someone was mishandling a real gun. Treat any gun as if it's a real gun with bullets in it. And if a friend shows you a gun or brings a gun to school, tell a teacher or parent about it as soon as you can. No gun should be picked up, pointed at someone, or handled in any way. Don't let a gun do that to you.
How can you tell what is safe to touch, taste, smell, or eat?
How can you tell what is safe to touch, taste, smell, or eat? Only food items are safe to touch, taste, smell, or eat, but you must always check food before you eat it. Looking to see if it's spoiled, to see if it smells or looks right. If you're unsure, ask an adult if the food is safe to eat. Some food items come with an expiration date stamped on them. If the food item is marked with a date that's passed already, most likely, you shouldn't eat it. This milk's expired, so I shouldn't drink it. Cool, this one hasn't expired yet. Dino-rific! Delicious and nutritious milk. Never touch a non-food household item without getting permission from an adult first. Right on. Some of these items contain poisonous chemicals that can be very dangerous and make you sick if you touch or smell them. Some can burn your skin or even kill you if they're swallowed. Don't get hurt by playing with any of those things. And if you have younger brothers or sisters around the house, have an adult put this stuff where they can't reach them. Or put a child safety lock on the cabinet. Got it. Never take medicines without adult supervision. If used correctly, medicines can be helpful. But if used incorrectly, without adult supervision, they can make you sick or even kill you. That's good to know. So don't put any of this stuff in your mouth or on your skin unless you get permission from an adult first. One more thing. If you see a fly, cockroach, or other bug crawling around the house, don't go in here trying to blast them with some of that stuff. Ask your parent or other adult to help you do it. Or use your shoe.
Fake cockroach used. No real bugs were injured during taping.
Why should you refuse to go inside the house of a person you don't know well?
Hey, kid, what you doing? Nothing. You want to come in and watch some TV? No.
I don't know this man. He's a stranger. This leads me to another safety tip. Why should you refuse to go inside the house of a person you don't know well?
Hey, come on in. There's a great movie on. And it's air conditioned. Come on.
Some people, whom you might not know well, may try to get you to go inside their house.
Come on.
Because they may want to do something that is wrong, harmful, or even dangerous to you. Never go inside a person's house or in their yard alone unless your parents or guardians are with you or have given you their permission first.
Oh, come on, kid. I got some baby birds I want to show you.
No thanks. I have to go. Always say no to an invitation to come inside, even if they have a pet or a movie they want to show you. Walk away and immediately tell a trusted adult what's happened.
Oh, come on, kid. Look, I got a gift for you. It'll go great with your slinky.
No thanks. Never accept a gift from a stranger, and never go inside a stranger's house.
Well, wait. I had popsicles, too.
If you are home alone and someone calls or knocks on the door, what should you do?
If you're home alone and someone knocks on the door or calls, what should you do? Never answer the phone if you're home alone, because the caller could ask questions and find out if you are alone.
Hi, Retrobell, it's Mom. I'll be home at 5:30 for dinner.
That was my mom that called. I know the number to call her back by heart. If it had been someone else, I could safely call my parents and give them the message.
Cool.
Hello, pizza guy. Anybody home?
I like pizza, but I didn't order pizza. Never answer the door or speak to anyone who comes to the door when you're home alone. And always make sure that you keep the doors and windows locked. Always. Hey, keep away from windows when someone is at the door or outside walking around. And
be very quiet.
Shh.
People may use many different tricks to try to get you to answer the phone or the door, like telling you it's an emergency, or that they have food to deliver, or repairs to make. Whatever it is, when you're home alone, don't answer the phone or the door. Better safe than sorry.
If you are in an unsafe situation at the mall, what should you do?
The mall! Stores, shopping, cool stuff!
Hey! If you're in an unsafe situation at the mall, what should you do?
You should always stay with the adults who are responsible for you when you're in a store or at the shopping mall.
Right on!
If you become separated from the parent or guardian that brought you, stay calm and immediately tell someone who works at the mall or a police officer what has happened.
Remember, never talk to strangers or walk around alone trying to find the adults that brought you there.
This can just end up making you even more lost than you already are.
Remember the five W's when telling someone what has happened to you. Who are you with? What do they look like? When did you last see them? Where did you last see them? And then ask yourself why you're lost and how you can keep this from happening again.
Some things you can do to stay safe while shopping at the mall or store is to only go shopping with your parents or with people your parents have given you permission to go with.
I call this shopping with a buddy.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Retro Bill.
Always stay with at least one other person when you're at the mall.
Never go into a public restroom alone.
Okay.
Immediately tell someone who works at the mall if you become separated from the persons or persons you are with.
One surefire way to know whether or not you are speaking with somebody who works at the mall is to look for a security guard in uniform or with a store employee who has a name tag like Jimbo.
Keep your personal possessions, such as your wallet, purse, or backpack, close to you at all times.
If someone grabs you or your possessions, yell loudly, doing whatever you can to get the attention of others. Hey, that guy stole my purse!
If a stranger grabs you, yell loudly to get the attention of others and jab your elbows and twist and punch to get away.
And move quickly toward other people or someone who works at the mall or a policeman and tell them what has happened.
If a stranger, a man or a woman, should approach you and ask you in a kind way to go with them, yell, no! I don't want to go with you.
And immediately tell someone you trust what has happened.
Right on.
Stores and malls are busy, crowded places. And although they can be fun, you should always practice good safety when shopping.
But if you do get lost, stay calm. Don't walk around looking lost. And go right to an adult who works at the mall, a security guard, or a policeman for help.
If you shop smart and you shop safe, shopping can be a lot of fun.
Hey, my car's over there, everybody.
Cool.
I might have to come back for the pony.
Why should you let people who are responsible for you know where you are?
Mom, Dad, I'm going over to Kukla, Fran, and Ollie's.
Okay, Retro Bill. Stay safe and play smart.
Don't forget to look both ways before crossing the street. And don't talk to strangers.
Okay, see you for dinner.
Hey. Why should you let people who are responsible for you know where you are?
Because your parents and guardians care about you, and they need to know where you are at all times.
Always be where your parents or guardians expect you to be, especially after school.
Always get permission ahead of time if you're planning to go to a friend's house, the neighborhood playground, or some other place after school.
And always know the name of the person who's supposed to look after you and where and how that person can be reached.
This is where your emergency contact list comes in handy.
Your contact list will give you the phone numbers of where your parents or guardians can be reached in an emergency. But try and memorize this stuff.
B4.
Hey, you sank my battleship.
Sorry.
Let's do something else, Retro Bill. Let's go play in the park.
Okay.
Let me call my mom and dad first to get permission.
And remember, always call your parents or guardian whenever plans change during the day. Get permission. Be responsible.
My goldfish are gone. They didn't tell me where they were going.
See how worried you get when something you love is missing and you don't know where it is? What if your pet or favorite toy was missing and you didn't know where it was?
You'd be upset too. So imagine how your mom and dad or other person responsible for you feels when they don't know where you are.
Pretty upset.
Right on. Since my goldfish didn't call, they could have at least left a note.
Dear Retro Bill, went to the neighbor's pool for a swim. Be back at 5 p.m. Love, Walt and Lily.
It's nice to know where they are.
See how important it is to let the person responsible for you know where you are? That way they're not out driving all around looking for you. They know right where you are.
Oh, and if you don't get permission to do something or go somewhere, go directly home.
What should you do if someone tries to touch you in ways you don't like?
What should you do if someone tries to touch you in ways you don't like? There are some people whom you might know and trust who may try to trick or force you into doing harmful things that involve body touching or showing body parts. That's bad. You have the right to say no and to tell a parent or other responsible adult if anything like this happens to you. Your bodies are your own, private property, and you can take action to protect yourself against bad touching.
Like where your bathing suit covers you.
Saying no loudly to anyone who tries to touch you in ways you don't like or tries to get you to take your clothes off. And always tell a parent or other adult responsible for you about any actions by someone that may have made you feel uncomfortable. And don't feel guilt or shame if a person tries to get you to do bad things. It's never your fault. Remember, you're the owner of your body, and you need to protect your body by saying no to unwanted touching, and by getting lots of rest, eating right, and exercising. Oh, there is good touching, like a high five, or a handshake for a job well done, or a hug from your parent, guardian, or other family member. As long as someone isn't touching you where your bathing suit covers you, it's okay. Sometimes you may have to be checked by a medical doctor and be asked to undress or have your private parts touched or looked at. This should only happen during a doctor's visit when your parent or guardian knows about it and is present.
You're okay, Retro Bill.
Cool.
When are drugs helpful or harmful?
When are drugs helpful or harmful? Medicines and common household products contain drugs and may be helpful or harmful. Medicines can be helpful if used correctly or harmful if used incorrectly. Always follow household safety rules when dealing with medicines or other household products. Never touch, taste, or smell any medicine or household cleaning product without getting permission from an adult, parent, or guardian in charge first. Never take medicines on your own. Only a doctor, medical professional, your parent, guardian, or other trusted adult should make that decision for you.
Right on.
Oh, and never take anyone else's medicine. Never. The safest thing to do is stay out of the medicine cabinet and away from other household products.
Right on.
What is a drug? A drug is any substance other than food that can change the way the body works. There are legal drugs like aspirin, cough syrup, vapor rub, or vitamins. And then there are dangerous, illegal drugs like marijuana, cocaine, or heroin. These illegal drugs are always bad for you. They can get you into big trouble, get you sick, or even kill you.
Man.
Don't do illegal drugs, and don't touch, taste, or smell household cleaning products or medicines at home either. Have an adult show you what to take when you're not feeling well. If you try to decide yourself and make a mistake, you could make yourself a lot sicker. So be safe by being smart and ask an adult to show you what to take so that medicine can do what it's supposed to do, make you feel better. Thanks. Good reminder. Always keep medicines and cleaning products out of reach of younger children, which is anyone younger than you. You're welcome.
How are tobacco, alcohol, and other dangerous drugs harmful?
How are tobacco, alcohol, and other dangerous drugs harmful? Tobacco and alcohol are harmful drugs and illegal for kids to purchase. Marijuana is also a harmful drug and illegal for everyone.
All medicines are drugs and can be harmful if used incorrectly.
Right on.
Take safe action when approached with offers to try tobacco, alcohol, marijuana, or other dangerous and illegal drugs. Simply refuse any offer.
Cigarette?
No.
Beer?
No.
Pipe?
No.
Whiskey?
No.
Cigar?
No.
Wine?
No.
Chewing tobacco?
Ugh. Marijuana?
No.
Hey, Retro Bill, I got this from home. You want it?
That's not my medicine. No way.
Never take anyone else's medicine. Never.
Got it.
Never take medicines on your own. Only a doctor, medical professional, your parent, guardian, or other trusted adult should make that decision for you.
Think of your body as this blender. When you're young, your body's clean and healthy. Your heart beats heartily. Your lungs breathe strongly. And your blood runs through your veins unobstructedly. And your body gets its energy from good food and water
and exercise.
Delicious and nutritious and healthy. Now, let's imagine that this blender is your body again. Only this time, we're going to put dangerous alcohol, tobacco, and other illegal and harmful drugs into your body. This is what you do to your healthy heart, lungs, and teeth when you put bad things in your body, like beer, wine, cigarettes, cigars, chewing tobacco, marijuana, cocaine. And when you drink, smoke, or snort this stuff, this is what it looks like inside your body. Sick, isn't it?
This could be your body if you take dangerous and harmful drugs or alcohol.
Would you drink or eat this stuff?
No.
Good.
Because it's all this junk that gives you heart disease, lung cancer, liver disease, rotting teeth, and mouth cancer.
This stuff is extremely dangerous and can make you sick or even kill you. And remember, drugs, alcohol, and cigarettes can be habit forming. Once you start putting this garbage in your body, you'll want more and more of it until you're sickened, addicted, and dead.
Yuck.
How can you say no?
How can you say no?
No.
Saying no when a situation is unsafe or dangerous is an important part of your personal safety plan. You should always say no when pressured by your friends or adults to do something that is unsafe or that doesn't seem right to you. There are four steps to follow when saying no. One, know when a situation is unsafe or harmful. Two, say no. Three, go away from the person who is pressuring you. Four, tell a parent, guardian, or other trusted adult what has happened.
Watch me put the four steps of saying no into practice.
Hey, Coach.
Well, hello there, Retro Bill.
What you doing, my motivational buddy?
Well, my big-haired friend, I'm getting ready to drive me some golf balls. You know what they say.
Tomorrow's a new day.
Yeah, well, I was thinking practice makes perfect.
Yeah? Why the blindfold?
New invention.
Huh? The blindfold?
Yeah, well, that's funny. No, blindfold golf, and it's going to be huge.
It's going to be dangerous.
Let's see. Over the oak tree, through the schoolyard, just over little Timmy's head. You see Timmy right there?
Oh, yeah.
And into the hole.
This can't be good. One, I know that this is something I don't want to be a part of.
My bad. Your turn.
Two, say no. And make sure that your posture clearly demonstrates that you are very sure of yourself. This way the person or persons you're saying no to will know that you mean no.
Oh, come on, Tiger. It's your turn.
No, Coach.
All right.
Three, walk away. Explain that you are leaving and then go. This will get you away from a bad situation and keep you from getting pressured any further. Coach, I don't want to play your silly game. I think it's dangerous, and somebody's going to get into big trouble. I'm leaving.
Well, suit yourself there, Retro.
Luckily, I followed the four steps of saying no. I knew when to say no, I calmly and firmly said no, and I quickly walked away. Oh, always tell a parent, guardian, or the police if you have to what has happened. Now you know how to say no, and you can use these four steps whenever someone offers you cigarettes, alcohol, drugs, or anything else that you think is unsafe or harmful.
What are you feeling?
What are you feeling? Knowing what emotion you are feeling and why you are feeling that way is the first step in expressing your emotions. The expression on a person's face, including your own, can help you see how a person feels or express how you feel. A smile means you're happy. Like if you got a new toy or a good grade on a test. A frown means you're sad or depressed. Like if your dog ran away. Your head hung low and avoiding eye contact is a sign of embarrassment. Like if you dropped the ball and lost the game. Or if your teacher called on you and you didn't know the answer to something. Proud, chest out, shoulders back, head held high, as if you made the game-winning catch, or the teacher called on you and you didn't know the answer. Angry, somebody's calling you names and you're tired of it, or your baby brother or sister did something that really makes you mad.
Scared, like when you think something's in your closet or under your bed, or when you're home alone and it's dark outside.
That one scares me. Facial expressions and body posture show our moods and what we might be feeling. Remember, there are no good feelings or bad feelings. What matters is how we deal with our feelings and the feelings of others. Ask yourself, what are you feeling right now? And how are you letting others know with your expression? I don't know about you, but I'm happy.
What should you do when angry?
What should you do when you're angry? Everyone feels angry sometimes, and you can deal with your anger in a healthy way so that no one gets hurt physically or emotionally. When you get angry, here's the four steps to controlling your anger.
Huh? Whoa! Stop! That's step one of controlling your anger. Freeze! Halt! Pause! Buen momento, por favor! Step two, calm down. Take a breath and count to 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Whoa. Count to 10 slowly.
1, 2, 3.
And think happy thoughts. Use self-talk or talk to others.
You know how to work this slinky, Retro Bill.
Come on, buddy.
Three, think. Choose a result that will not hurt you, others, or other things. Four, act. Do the right thing. Sometimes we can help a friend to deal with their anger by listening, or by lending a helping hand when we can.
You can use the four steps to controlling your anger. Whenever you feel angry, whether you're feeling angry because you're being teased, or feeling left out, or maybe you're just angry because things aren't going your way. Oh, sometimes you or a friend may need help dealing with your anger. If you or a friend get so angry that it may lead to fighting, make sure you seek help from your parent, a teacher, or other trusted adult so that you get a hold of your anger before your anger gets a hold of you.
How do you avoid fights?
How do you avoid fights? Fighting is not a good way to solve your problems. You can learn to control your anger and choose peaceful solutions to your problems. You can try many ways to solve your problems peacefully. Be fair and kind to others and respect their feelings. Practice a give and take way of playing. Share and take turns. Play by and follow the rules, treating others like you would like to be treated. Fairly. Go away from situations if others stay angry and want to fight. Remember, you can always get help from an adult in charge when you need it. Remember, the best way to avoid a fight is to be fair, share, be nice, wait your turn, listen to what the other person feels, and think about how the other person feels.
Playing is safer and a lot more fun when you don't fight.
Remember, whenever possible, avoid fighting.
What do gangs do to hurt you and your neighborhood?
What do gangs do to hurt you and your neighborhood? Gangs hurt people and things in the neighborhood. They often break the law and make people afraid to participate in neighborhood activities, like playing outside, walking to school, or just going to the park. Gangs are bad, and they mean trouble for you. Always avoid gang activities by staying away from places where gang members hang out and never answering gang members who ask you to join them. And always tell a parent, guardian, trusted adult, or the police if gang members threaten you or ask you to do things that are dangerous or harmful.
Right on!
Join together with other friends and adults in your community to make your town safer by having meetings and discussing problems at school. Perhaps you can all get together to clean up litter, paint over graffiti, or even plant flowers and trees with your friends to help make your community and schools safer. Get the police involved to help you solve gang problems in your community. And remember, your D.A.R.E. officers are always there to help you keep safe, drug-free, and violence-free. D.A.R.E. to care, and D.A.R.E. to do the right thing. Thanks for watching, everybody. Make sure you watch this tape over and over again so that you'll have your personal safety plan memorized. And the safety tips will become part of everyday living for you. This is your D.A.R.E. safety buddy, Retro Bill, saying make wherever you go a better place because you were there. See ya!